It's Keke, aka Shyfacediva. Thank you for joining me in the kitchen again. Today we're going to be doing my Italian sausage pasta bake. This one has definitely been in rotation these past 6 months. It heats up really well. You can take it for your lunch the next day. Right now I'm cooking and crumbling up 2 pounds of Italian sausage. Sometimes I use mild, sometimes I use hot. I'm going to give you different alternatives along the way. As if you don't want to use sausage, you can use beef, you can use turkey, you can use ground chicken, ground pork, whatever you have on hand. Just make sure you season the meat well. The thing about Italian sausage, I don't have to put much seasoning in this because it's seasoned really well. I'm going to continue to cook this and I'll be right back. While you're cooking your meat, go ahead and preheat your oven to 350. Once you cook your meat, you want to drain it out depending on what type of meat you're using. I'm going to add in some minced garlic, which is optional. I'm going to add in some sliced mushrooms, which are optional. I'm going to add in a little bit of onion right from the freezer. Also a little bit of pepper right from the freezer. Okay, I'm just going to mix that up. I'm going to start adding the pasta sauce. It's going to depend on how much sauce you're going to add, depending on how much you're making, and also depending on how much pasta you add to your mixture. The more pasta you add, the more sauce you need, because you don't want it to dry out when it's cooking. I'm going to mix that in. I at least always have 3 jars of sauce so I can get the right consistency I want. Okay, I'm going to add the second jar. Remember, we still have to add our pasta. If you did 1 pound of meat, you might just need about 1.5 jars of pasta sauce. Okay, I'm going to add in my pasta, which I cooked earlier. And I did about a little over 1/2 pound. I did not use the whole box because that would have been too much. Okay, before I add in more pasta sauce, I'm going to mix this up to see where I'm at. You can use any type of pasta you want. Okay, I'm going to add in another half, just a half, not the whole thing this time, because when it bakes, you want it to stay really moist. And plus, it's a lot of meat, it's 2 pounds. Okay, we got the perfect texture. Okay, before you add your seasonings, you want to take a separate utensil, like a plastic utensil, and you want to try it out to make sure it's seasoned good. You might not want to add any more seasoning because the sausage got seasoning and the pasta sauce has seasoning. Everybody has different tastes. By adding Italian sausage, you wouldn't need much seasoning at this point. As if you use ground beef or turkey or chicken or pork, you're going to have to season that meat. Okay, since I'm using red sauce, I'm going to add in Italian seasoning. You can also use Alfredo sauce if you don't want to use red pasta sauce. I rotate sometime between the two. Okay, I'm going to add in a little complete. And that's all I'm going to add to this. And it's seasoned really well. Okay, you want to take a 9x13 baking dish and you want to spray it with cooking spray. You want to start adding your mixture. It's going to make about 2 layers. You want it to stay nice and juicy when it starts baking. But it's up to you if you want to add less sauce and more pasta, less sauce. You just got to do what works for you. But I will have my exact measurements below. Also, this makes a lot. If you don't want to make this much, you can cut the recipe in half. Now I'm going to be layering it with mozzarella shredded cheese. Okay, you want to add your second layer. Like I said, this heats up really well for leftovers. You just put foil over it and heat up 350 until it heats through. Before you add in your baking dish, if you want to, you can let it cook for about 10 minutes on the stove top just so it can warm through. But I just let mine cook the rest of the way in the oven. I mean, it's already done. You know, it just has to heat through. Okay, it's the last of it. Last thing you do is just layer it again with cheese. This time I'm going to put my cheddar first and put the mozzarella on top. Okay, so it's going to go in the oven on 350 for 30-35 minutes until it heats through and the cheese melts. So before serving, to give you some guidance, you can cut it, especially if you're doing portions. And you can cut it until how big and small the pieces you want. I cut it into 10 servings. See, when I took some out, it's still nice and juicy. That will conclude this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.